Okay, now let us see the technology considered in brief.
GPS. So, what is GPS? GPS stands for Global Positioning System. Basically, in GPS module, the GPS receiver gets the parameters from satellites nearby. So, these parameters include position, speed, altitude, time, etc. These parameters are converted into NMEA format, which can be shown in the sentences. As you can see here, these sentences also called as CSVs, that is, comma separated values. So, there are four different CSVs starting with GPGGA, GPRMC, GSV and GSA. So, these parameters that are required for our application can be decoded from GPRMC. After decoding, we can see the data like this. As you can see here, time, date, location, speed and angle is extracted from above NMEA sentences or the CSVs that we were talking about.
The next technology that we used is GPRS. GPRS stands for General Packet Radio Service. Now you might have a question that why GPRS? So let me clear your doubt by explaining few advantages of GPRS over other technologies. They are cost, constant connection, mobility and speed.
GPS and GPRS being the basic technologies used, now let me explain you the brief description of proposed solution. Every vehicle is integrated with a device in it. The future vehicles with this device in them can communicate with other vehicles nearby. As you can see here, there are four cars, each of which is communicating with every other car. So this helps them take their next step safely without any crash. Now coming to the hardware part of the device. The device mainly includes a module in which GPS and GPRS facility is embedded in it and a controller in which it is used to process the incoming data. Here comes the working of proposed solution. This is basic block diagram of the idea to be implemented. As I explained earlier, the device in the car gets GPS data in NMEA format from GPS satellite, and after processing, this data is uploaded to the cloud server through cellular network. From the server, the data can be seen from anywhere in the world through the internet connection, which is provided by the GPRS that is embedded in our device. This is what happens in backend. Coming to the front end, for the user to see the data, a GUI is developed which might look like this. Here you can see the GUI clearly shows the vehicle type, speed and the direction it is heading to in a map. Now let us see some common situations where our solution helps in reducing genuine number of accidents. Here you can see two cars, one is yellow and the other one is black. The black car just after crossing the curved road decelerates because of some obstacle. But yellow car may not know this situation and moves at the same speed as it was moving before without any deceleration, which will result in crash. This is one more scenario in which three cars are moving one behind the other. The first car is in blind spot to the third car because of the car in between them. So any action by the first car, let's say sudden braking, cannot be seen by the third car and might result in crash. So if the vehicles are installed with our device, all the above scenarios can be avoided easily as they can communicate with each other and make the next move accordingly. Now coming to the effectiveness of the solution, it is cost effective, user friendly, least maintained and easy to install, and the most important thing is less time to market as all the modules are available. Created using Powtoon.